Alright, Shalom. Back again with another lesson inspired through the Rekah Kodesh, which is the Holy Spirit. Want to give all praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS for teaching me this truth, and honors to all my fellow ministers that are teaching this same truth in 100% sincerity and diligence. Alright, and this is Democracy Now! 2 days ago, U.S. marks 100th anniversary of Tulsa Race Massacre, when white mob destroyed Black Wall Street. Now, what is a massacre? Massacre, to kill many beings indiscriminately, commonly in reference to those who are not in a condition to defend themselves. You see? Now, let's play. I'm going to play a portion of this clip. It's going into a trailer.
Wilson premieres on the History Channel. This is the trailer for Tulsa Burning, the 1921 race massacre.
The destruction was so complete. The suffering was so biblical. The betrayal was so profound.
Black communities deserve the opportunity to confront the past.
Our city has been stuck since then. Yeah. We've never recovered.
Tulsa was the best place in the nation for African Americans.
Have everything from hotels, theaters,
doctors, lawyers.
People refer to it as Black Wall Street.
Showing Black people that a new world was possible.
The Tribune published a story titled Nab Negro for Attacking Girl in an Elevator. It was a false narrative to keep Black people in their place, to reinforce white supremacy.
All across Tulsa, angry whites are now organizing.
They get their guns, they get their torches.
At that point, they start moving towards Greenwood.
All hell broke loose.
My mother says the white folks are killing the colored folks.
Firing into homes.
Bombs dropping from the air.
It was just an all-out massacre.
Not one of those men who participated in the race massacre were ever brought to justice.
The Tulsa Tribune refused to write anything about the massacre for more than 50 years. Victims were being buried in unmarked graves across the city. The reason we understand the history of the massacre is that certain survivors decided to talk about it.
My mother saw four men coming toward our house, and all of them had torches.
We would be looking for the remains of those who were lost so tragically.
This is so beautiful and sad at the same time.
We need to do something about what happened in Tulsa.
There cannot be any justice till there is proper respect, restitution, and repair.
Yeah, see, you so-called Black people, you're not going to get respect, you're not going to get justice. You ain't going to get it from these people, man. All right, the justice is going to come from on high, because it's the Heavenly Father that's brought these things upon us. All right, let's go to Deuteronomy, the 28th chapter. Deuteronomy 28, verse 15. Consequences for disobedience. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Verse 16. Cursed shalt thou be in the city, and cursed shalt thou be in the field. Cursed shall be thy basket and thy store. You see, and they called Greenwood, they called it Black Wall Street. It was a prosperous community. And what happened? All your stores got bombed. They got destroyed. And justice has never been served, you know, to this date. Because why? The curses, they have followed us and overtaken us. This is Deuteronomy 28, verse 45. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, thy power to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and a wonder, and upon thy seed forever. See, when you look at this tragic, you know, event, this thing is a sign. It's a wonder, you know? And this thing, and we the only people that fit these scriptures. That, see, and this is how the Lord had it to where you would be able to identify who the Israelites would be through these signs and wonders, you know? and what's coming out. And it's funny because, and I'm gonna show a part from the beginning. You have survivors that are here giving their testimony, the 100-year-old survivors. So, you know, and it's beautiful because these Edomites about to pay, man. They about to pay. Check this out.
Held a hearing to address the ongoing impacts of the Tulsa massacre. Three African-American survivors testified in favor of reparations. Viola Fletcher, her younger brother, Hughes Van Ellis, who's 100 years old, and 105-year-old.
So these are people that witnessed the devil, man. They witnessed him. They witnessed him. Listen to their testimony.
Leslie Benningfield Randall. This is part of their testimony, beginning with Viola Fletcher.
I'm a survivor of the Tulsa Race Massacre. 2 weeks ago, I celebrated my one.
Oh, and I want to say this is fair use. I am not in any shape or form using this video to make any monetary gain. This is all for educational purposes only. Fair use.
107th birthday. Today, I'm visiting Washington, D.C. for the first time in my life. I'm here seeking justice, and I'm asking my country to acknowledge what happened in Tulsa in 1921. The night of the massacre, I was awakened by my family. My parents and five siblings were there. I was told we had to leave, and that was it. I will never forget the violence of the white mob when we left our home. I still see black men.
And why won't you forget the violence of the white mob? Because these are the Edomites. All right, this is Obadiah chapter 1, verse 9. Oh, man, hold up. Verse 9, and thy mighty men, O Teman, shall be dismayed to the end that everyone of the Mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter. For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever. You see, for the violence they committed against thy brother Jacob. Genesis 27:41, and Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, the days of my mourning for my father are at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob. You see? He said, then I'm gonna kill Jake. That's why the MO of these people has always been to kill so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans.
And being shot, black bodies lying in the street. I still smell smoke and see fire. I still see black businesses being burned. I still hear airplanes flying overhead. I hear the screams. I have lived through the massacre every day. Our country may forget this history, but I cannot. I will not, and other survivors do not, and our descendants do not.
That's right. Don't forget these goddamn devils, man. Let's get Ecclesiastes, the third chapter. The hell with they goddamn courts acknowledging some shit, man. We seeking the righteous judge. This is Ecclesiastes 3:17. I said in my heart, God shall judge the righteous and the wicked, for there is a time there for every purpose and for every work.
We live with it every day, and the thought of what Greenwood was and what it could have been. We aren't just black and white pictures on a screen. We are flesh and blood. I was there when it happened. I'm still here.
That's right. It seems like justice in America is always so slow or not possible for black people.
Three African-American survivors of the Tulsa Race Massacre, making history as they testified before Congress just ahead of the centennial of the race massacre this Monday. The Department of Homeland Security has said events commemorating the massacre could be a target for white supremacists. President Joe Biden still plans to travel to Tulsa on Tuesday. This Sunday, a documentary by award-winning filmmaker Stanley Nelson.
All right, so yeah, that's the point. All right, wrap it on up, get a couple more precepts. Let's get Habakkuk 2, verse 16. It says, thou art filled with shame for glory. Drink thou also, and let thy foreskin be uncovered. The cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee, and shameful spewing shall be on thy glory. Yeah, man. So this is coming out right now, you know, because these devils about to get judged. They about to pay for what they did, you know. And here it is, you got 100-year-old Jakes that are here today that say, yeah, this happened. You know, I remember the smell. I remember, the you know, them coming with torches. And, you know, I remember them dropping bombs. Oh, yeah. That's in the scriptures, too. Revelation 13 and verse 12 or 13, we get the point. And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. And that's what he did. He made fire come down. That's what them bombs were. And them bombs will drop from the heavens, right? And straight destroyed Jake community, man. This is Psalms 50 and 19. Thou givest thy mouth to evil, and thy tongue framest deceit. And what they said happened? They said that, how did they say they did it? They made up some lie. Let me see if I can play it real quick.
In 21 race massacre.
The destruction was so complete. The suffering was so biblical. The betrayal was so profound.
Black communities deserve the opportunity to confront the past.
Our city has been stuck since then. Yeah. We've never recovered.
Tulsa was the best place in the nation for African Americans.
We have everything from hotels, theaters,
doctors, lawyers.
People refer to it as Black Wall Street.
Showing Black people that a new world was possible.
Tribune published a story titled Nab Negro for Attacking Girl in an Elevator.
That's it. So they came up with a false story, right? That somebody, Edomite, was attacked in the elevator.
A false narrative to keep Black people in their place, to reinforce white supremacy.
Yup, and that's in the scriptures too. The accuser of the brethren. Let's go back to Revelation, the 12th chapter. Revelation 12, verse 10. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now has come salvation and strength in the kingdom of our God and the power of his anointed. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. See, that's what he do. He be up here creating these false nets, just like they deal with Emmett Till, saying he whistled at a so-called white girl. And this was a young man, like Emmett Till was like 12 years old or something like that, man. And they came up with an accusation against him, you know, and used that to justify slaying him. And that's the same thing they about to do now. All right, Psalms 50 and 19, thou givest thy mouth to evil, and thy tongue frameth deceit. Thou sittest and speakest against thy brother, thou slanderest thine own mother's son. These things hast thou done, and I kept silence. Thou thoughtest that I was altogether such as one as thyself, but I will reprove thee and set them in order before thine eyes. So that's happening now. All right, the sons of Israel are being set up right now in front of you devils, cussing you devils out, and then telling you your judgment. Oh shit, I wanted that. It was Ezekiel 35. Let's get that. Ezekiel 35, prophesy against Mount Seir, which Mount Seir was the dwelling place of Esau. So that's saying prophesy against the Edomites. Ezekiel 35 and 4. I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am Yahweh Bashem Yahushah, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of that calamity, in the time that iniquity had an end. Hey, and you can apply that now, because this was, you know, back then in the ancient world, you know, during the time of the Babylonians. But shit, even during the time of the, we had issues with them when we were coming out of Egypt. But also now, because after the Tulsa, this was about 1865. So this was about roughly about 60 years, 50, 60 years out of chattel slavery. So this could be that iniquity coming to an end, and they were shedding the blood of Israel by force of the sword, you know, even then. You know, here it is, Jake then did 400 years of slavery, and they out here trying to build something, and you know something for ourselves, and here y'all come with the sword, man. You see, verse 6, therefore as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood, and blood shall pursue thee. Sith thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. So blood is coming for you, devils, for you Edomites. Yeah, the Lord gonna get you, man. He gonna get you. That's right. Thus will I make Mount Seir most desolate, and cut off from it him that passeth out and him that returneth. And I will fill his mountains with his slain men, in thy hills and in thy valleys, and in all thy rivers shalt thou fall that are slain with the sword. I will make thee perpetual desolations, and is in thy city shall not return. And ye shall know that I am Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. Right, because what did you touch? You touched the apple of the Lord's eye. Zechariah 2 and 8, for thus saith the Lord of hosts. Matter of fact, we'll start at 7. Deliver thyself, O Zion, that dwellest with the daughter of Babylon. So that's us right now. All right, Zion is to Zion 1, the monument, all right, of Israel. And we're dwelling in the daughter of Babylon, Babylon the Great. All right, and how do we deliver ourselves? We're delivering ourselves by coming back to the Lord in repentance and abiding in his truth. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, after the glory have he sent me unto the nations which spoiled you. For he that toucheth you toucheth the apple of his eye, man. So, you know, hey, you devils got some pain to do, man, because the Lord was mad with us. Oh, what's that? You further the affliction. Let me see if I can get that. The iniquity had an end, but you further the affliction. All these goddamn ads. Where is that at? What iniquity had it in for the affliction? Yeah, Zechariah 1 and 14. So the angel that communed with me said unto me, cry thou, saying, thus saith the Lord of hosts, I am jealous for Jerusalem and for Zion with a great jealousy. And that's going into you touching, you know, spoiling us too, what you did with us. You know, that going into the Lord's great jealousy. And I am very sore displeased with the heathen that are at ease, because you devils did all this dirt on us, and y'all out here at ease. Y'all ain't apologizing. Well, now y'all trying to, you know, do a little something, you know, cutting down statues and shit. And, you know, you got some Edomites on video bowing down and, you know, apologizing and spanking themselves and shit. But that ain't shit, man. The majority of you heathen are at ease. For I was but a little displeased, and they helped forward the affliction. All right, so the Lord was a little displeased with us, and you devils just took that shit to the extreme, you know, you're playing dodgeball with our babies and, you know, all kind of shit. I forgot what that shit was called, Dodgers or something, where you know, man, I don't even remember how the brother said it was, but little games you devils did with us, and using our babies as gator baits and tying us to horses and making them run separate directions and all kind of shit, man. Y'all devils got to pay for hanging us and all that shit, man. Yeah, you know, you help forward the affliction. So I'm gonna go ahead and end that. I think that's all the pre's. Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and end there. All right, shalom.